May 21st, 2022, opening day of the Royal Aviation Museum of Western Canada. And the logo reminds me of the Salisbury House. Pretty cool, eh? Only one surviving in existence.
This?
I mean, it's, yep, Super 71.
Yes.
That's the Junker. Queen of the Hurricanes. Wow. The wing.
It's kind of weird that they just look like they're made out of aluminum foil.
Yeah, yeah, they look brittle.
Especially that one. Like, yeah. It's just hammered down, just thin aluminum foil.
Yeah, we'll take a closer look. Junker.
the damage that happened.
Yep, that's the only one that's existing.
Oh my God, that's so cool.
That's all it remains.
Just to actually see that damage that actually happened and remember to actually fix it.
Yeah.
That is cool.
That's where they tied their bus. That's where they tied the rope. See?
Wow.
I like that effect.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Oh, it's a beautiful aircraft.
Well,
really
it wasn't made in Canada. It was made in the United States by Stinson, of course, but it was used quite extensively as a bush plane, as you can see.
Yeah.
Of course, the significance of this one, can I think of a mask down the center?
Yeah, yeah.
The significance of this airplane is the canoe, because it could carry a canoe on either side, and prospectors would hire bush plane like this to carry them into the south, into the north, with a canoe and maybe two weeks worth of food, and they would drop them off, and the prospector would paddle around northern Canada looking for veins of nickel or copper or gold or whatever. That was a very common sight to see a bush plane with canoes strapped to the side.
Yeah.
And sometimes
that's
they
right
carry
there.
Two, one on each side. Sometimes they carry a canoe under the wing.
Yeah, I see it, the green one?
Yeah, I see that.
Neat.
But one of the things about coming here, I said, well, you know what, I'm gonna be a hero and tell them that they've got that canoe on there. Because if you, anything aerodynamic, you want to put the pointy end to the front, right?
Yeah,
but,
for sure.
So what they found out was, so I got straightened out on that pretty fast.
Oh.
what apparently if you put the pointy end to the front, it becomes its own airfoil.
Oh.
And it wants to take their airplane over here,
oh.
And the pilot doesn't have any control over that, right?
Oh,
right.
That
so
makes sense.
If you put the blunt end to the front, that interrupts the aerodynamics of the canoe, and now the pilot has control of the airplane, not the canoe.
The canoe is now just a passenger.
Yeah,
just it's one of those things you never think of.
That's right.
I would have thought the same thing you did.
Yeah.
Interesting. That is interesting.
How are you today? At least the rain is holding up.
Okay. Yeah. It's cool.
Yeah.
I never thought about that, would you?
Look at those tires, eh? Rubber thick tires. They're kind of cool, eh? Neat, eh?
I love
those wings. Just look so crude looking, like propellers. That's how they're fastened on there together.
Wait, are they?
I think so. I'm not sure.
Nope. No, those are good.
Hmm. Yes.
That wizard phone toy you have.
Right, right.
You know what I mean?
You mind if I tell you one little statistic about this?
Sure.
I find this interesting. Is that, it's called the Junker G52, of course, and there's thousands of these built in Germany.
Right.
Actually Spain built a few also, but anyway, the original, the first six were built with one motor. They found it was underpowered, so they put three motors on, one in each wing and one in the nose. So James Richardson bought one with one motor, and this one is the only one in the world that's been restored with one motor.
Wow.
One engine. I keep saying motor, it's engine.
Right.
One of the guys, the founders, he says, boats have motors, chainsaws have motors, airplanes have engines.
I have to remember that.
So anyway, like I said, the first, so they made the rest of them with three engines. But the original engines were made by a company called Bavarian Motorworks, BMW.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
But after the Second World War, BMW had the problems to never ever build engines again for Junkers.
Yeah.
At that point, BMW, they were already starting to make cars, so they just increased their production of cars. And of course, we know where that went because they make a good car.
Yes. Yeah, no kidding.
And to this day, BMW's logo is still a long way.
Really?
Really?
Right?
Cool.
Yep. So anyway, yeah. But the corrugation, the corrugated finish added strength to the airplane, but it added too much weight. If you can imagine, if you can iron out those corrugations, you could probably about with half the amount of material. Even though it would make for 93% aluminum. Mm-hmm. But by that time, newer, lighter materials were coming out. So that corrugation affected the mass down. But it was considered to be the biggest airplane in North America in the 1930s.
Really?
It could operate on wheel skis, that's the pontoon over there. And on pontoons, it operated on the Rin River, which was the original airplane.
Right.
You know where Poon's are right now? By St. Boniface, that area. That's where the original airport was.
Really?
Yeah. Airport on the river.
Wow, things have changed.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Big time.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, good. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
It's pretty packed up there, right?
Yeah, it's so small.
See how you crank it? Pretty cool. Can easily make it out of Lego.
I was just thinking that, yeah. The Lego plane.
Wow. Neat. love to be in the front of that, Jess?
Well, if we were on the ground, just kind of going down the highway, okay.
Be a great view.
Up in the air? Mm-hmm. Forget that. What is it? Functioning tool?
1928. This is a replica. Huh. So that's part of the engine, what was left of it. I like the what do you call it? Chicken wire front.
I like the little visors right there, so that's gonna protect you from anything.
It's pretty much like this, the race cars that they had back then. It was really...
It's like an octopus body, but like a hexapus.
Yes. Oh yeah, this is what was left of it. Not much. Yeah.
In the early 20th century, a series of major forest fires devastated large areas of northern Ontario, Alberta, and Saskatchewan, killing hundreds of people and leaving thousands more homeless. Fighting these fires was the responsibility of the federal government, but methods were often crude and ineffective. Once a fire was spotted, the rangers had to make their way to the site on foot or by canoe, and attempt to extinguish the blaze with axes, shovels, and buckets. All this changed with the arrival of aviation. Following the First World War, the Canadian Air Force established a series of air bases across Canada, including at Victoria Beach in Manitoba. Using war surplus Curtiss HS-2L and Felixstowe F-3 flying boats, in 1921, pilots stationed at Victoria Beach began flying experimental fire patrols over the forests surrounding Lake Winnipeg. When a fire was spotted, the pilot would land on a nearby lake or river so the crew could extinguish the blaze with hand tools. For more serious fires, the pilot would land at a nearby settlement to pick up heavier equipment like motorized pumps and hoses. These experimental flights proved highly successful, and in 1924, fire patrol duties were officially assigned to the now Royal Canadian Air Force. As well as building more air bases across Manitoba and Saskatchewan, the Air Force replaced its old wartime flying boats with newer models, like the Canadian Vickers Vedette, one of the first aircraft designed and built entirely in Canada. Smaller, lighter, and with a greater rate of climb, the Vedette was ideal for operations on the small lakes and rivers of northern Manitoba. In 1930, Natural Resources Management was transferred to the newly formed Manitoba Government Air Service, which continued to operate flying boats like the Vedette for another decade. The legacy of these early pioneers lives on in purpose-built amphibious flying boats like the Canadair CL-215 and CL-415 water bombers, which carry on the vital duty of protecting Canada's precious forests.
Wow. This is...
That's not what I'm feeling to my God.
Read that.
It was a harrowing experience. The pain from the noise, the sound, still kind of shakes me out.
Just like wood. I wouldn't want to stretch with that thing.
I was small with it.
That's because that's the main pilot.
Oh yeah, yeah. It's pretty big. Yeah, there's. Okay. You want to go for here?
Cool. Without Will Smith. Snowboard.
Yes.
I would need one that big to keep me balanced.
What is that thing?
Oh, like they don't have the write up. I still have no idea. That's the shiny, that chrome.
That'd be a good, conversation piece on your wall.
Good way to slash your legs.
Oh wow. This is cool. Oh, we can touch it, Jessica.
I can't reach it though. Why can't I touch that saw? Why can't I touch the sharp stuff? And the lead.
Yeah, I won't touch the lead.
It's off
the CF-100. Oh, you touch this. Just keep your foot down on the top part. Look at the gears.
The COVID.
Oh. Well, use this.
Oh, wow. That's cool. It's neat.
Scientist laboratory here. Jess, look at this one. Ooh.
Oh, look at this one. You're not playing with buttons with me. Play with buttons.
Oh, what's this do?
Oh. Doesn't matter. They're buttons.
Just missed the pilot, Jessica. Well, I passed.
What? Oh, wow. Look at this.
Oh, I see. That makes sense.
It's like a barbecue. More fuel. More fuel. Lots more fuel. I'm freezing. Freeze the barbecue.
Okay. But, okay.
It's a spiky part.
Oh, purple.
I gotta push that down. Oh, wow. Someone's gonna hurt themselves.
Shit, that'll hurt. Okay.
I'm suing. Okay.
That's the... Oh, they do call it a wasp. There's a wasp tuner.
They did it on purpose.
Oh, snowbird. Can go on top later. Oh, yeah.
Buttons and knobs.
I feel like I pulled that just for a joke.
Pull to release the pilot's feet. Not today, Junior. No.
I didn't.
Canada, owned by Transcanada Airlines, prior to becoming Air Canada. With a turboprop engine, you climb to high altitudes, 28,000 feet was ceiling height, or surface height. So, compared to a piston-powered aircraft, which could only go to about, because this had a pressurized cabin, it could go up to that height. In a piston-powered, you could not do that.
We'll say hi, then come out, double curry, double paddle.
Please do not attach the seat belts.
What is that young woman doing on the cover?
It's called skateboarding.
Skateboarding?
Yes. It's
similar to roller skating, but without the shoes. The wheels are attached to a board.
And you balance on it with your hands?
Yes, like you can, but I think it's meant to be ridden like a scooter. I think it's down in the place. The name is Nidhi, and it says that the skateboard is like a teeter-totter and is exhilarating and dangerous.
Well, you will not be getting one of those.
Oh, no, thank you. I'm very happy with my bicycle. It has the prettiest bell on it, and the tassels which hang off of the handlebars are fantastic. Nidhi, besides, I'm flying on an air fence. Can't get more.
Oh, cool.
Although,
what?
Is it dangerous to fly?
No.
How do you know?
Like this is meant that I've had to fly quite often. It's the safest form of transportation there is. And
curtains.
Here we are in Winnipeg. In a few short hours, we'll be in Montreal. When I was your age, we had to take a train, and it took several days. Now it's very brief, comparatively. It's a wondrous thing.
And it's safe?
Yes.
It smells like a barn.
It smells like Grandma's basement.
Able to see our house?
It smells like a barn.
Okay, that's worth it.
It's so awkward to get if something falls back there.
Yeah. Lost and found. Look at those. I like these.
Yeah.
I prefer to think I'm still here.
It's very 60s, eh?
Let's go to a Halloween set.
Whoa!
Where are we? I want to go to a Halloween set.
Yeah, I
want to
go where the crab.
Yeah,
crab.
Let's go to the crab.
It's so tiny. Total Value Village finds me.
Lifesavers. Is that toothpaste? No, for acne. Oh. Muscle aches. Wow.
I like the little Pond's jar.
Yeah. little bit of color in this.
Gold?
Yeah.
Kind of looks like baby poop. You can keep that in there. I'm an uncultured swine.
Probably what we saw over there.
Oh! Wait, oh, so that was the wave filling the line on the water then? Okay.
Surfboard?
Looks like, you know, some sharks got to it.
It's the same company that makes the other one you like over there. The same.
Oh, I'd be paying attention to the makers. It's a cool plane.
This one.